Hello friends, welcome to the channel Eli's Treasure of Knowledge. To get more information on library and information science, then make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single video. In this video, we will see the 5 laws of library science. Dr. S. R. Ranganathan is the father of library and information science. He proposed 5 laws of library science in 1931. The laws were first published in Ranganathan's classic book entitled 5 Laws of Library Science in 1931. These laws are the fundamental laws of library science. These laws tell us about what should be done in the library field to make the library organizable, manageable, efficient, and to universalize its services. Let's see the 5 laws. First law is, books are for use. Second law, every reader his or her book. Third law is, every book its reader. And the fourth law is, save the time of the reader. And the fifth law is, library is a growing organism. We are going to see these laws one by one. Let's see the first law. Earlier books were for preservation. And also few privileged people can get access to books. But this law changed the perspective that books are for use, not only for privileged people, but also for every person. So Ranganathan suggests that library collection should be used in a proper way. And for that purpose, to make effective this rule, librarian or authority should make efforts. Library location. The location of the library building is to be easily accessible by users. It should be located at the central place where users can conveniently reach. At the same time, location should be free from noise and other disturbance. Library hours. The use of library depends upon the opening and closing hours of the library. If the library functioning hours are favorable to the users, they will use the library frequently without any hurdle. For example, public library hours. The uses of public libraries are different from any academic library, so the library should be kept open even on the holidays, because users will be free from all their work and get more time to use the library. But if it is an academic library, it should be kept open in lunchtime also. It will help users to come and utilize their time. Therefore, the library should open for maximum hours in a day according to the need of its users. Library building. Furniture and equipment. This law demands that proper attention should be given to planning and managing library building. It should be functional. It should be attractive, neat and clean, and easy access to the users. It should be airy by ventilation and lighting should be proper. As far as possible, we can use and display new arrivals, charts or notice board. Daily motivational quotes. These ideas should be provided at the front of the main building entrance. Suitable space and sitting arrangement should be there. In this technology time, the library should provide devices and tools like computers, charger points, Wi-Fi facilities, and even headphones. The devices and tools are equally important to play a role in maximum use of the library. Also, the interior and exterior of the library should be inviting. It should be decorative and pleasant so that users can sit for a longer time. Book selection. Book selection is the important part of every library. If the selection of a book is not proper and not according to the need of the users, the use of books shall not be maximum. To make effective use of books, the selection of books should be useful, easy, attractive, and high level, which is useful to the users and readers. The use of the library is only possible when the library has adequate, skilled, qualified staff who is capable of having subject knowledge as well as having knowledge of how to guide the library user. The library should provide open access service to all users. Second law. Every reader his or her book. This law is user-oriented law. According to the second law, every reader should be provided his or her book. But earlier, it was not like that. Only few people who belong to the library can get access. So this law breaks this statement and allows every user to use the library materials. The library should provide sufficient funds to run the library and to utilize the available funds and implement library rules. Library staff should be well aware with library collection and do their job with full energy and responsibility. They should be fully aware with the use of devices and techniques used in the library, like bibliographic tools, reference books, and their use. They should be aware of the problem and need of their users. Third law is, every book its reader. This law teaches us to emphasize the availability of readers to each and every book. The law stands for maximum use of books by their reader and appropriate techniques to be taken to publicize the books of the library. To achieve this objective, libraries should perform few important duties in a proper way. They should provide open access. Earlier, when the books were preserved in lock and key, but Ranganathan's movement changed this concept in our country, and an open access system was introduced in the library, where readers are allowed to go inside the library and see the collection and select their desired books. This concept helps readers to know the availability of collection, and also it increases the library use. The next responsibility is proper shelf arrangement of books according to the classification scheme. If books are not arranged in a helpful sequence, the rich collection of books in a library is useless. It has been observed that readers are attracted to the library if the collection is maintained in helpful sequence. So the shelf arrangement of books should be done by library properly. And readers should also take care of those arranged books. They should not replace or change the location of arranged books on shelf. A library should display new arrivals. A new matter or things is always an attraction of every person. So libraries should get a benefit of this habit of human nature. And for that, new arrivals or books received in the library should be displayed at the main entrance of the library. Library catalog. Library catalog is an important part of every library. A library catalog means a list of books available in a particular library. It should be provided to its readers or users for clarity and let them know the collection of available books. Reference service. A reader is new to the library, so they need personal assistance to use a library in an efficient way. So the personal assistance by the staff, which is called reference service, provides a relation between readers and the books. The library should arrange book exhibition. By providing this service, books get a chance to find their readers, which can be done through special occasions. For example, the books related with the language or environment should be displayed and distributed during the World Environment Day or any particular language day. Coming to the fourth law, save the time of the users. It states that the user of the library will be given high consideration, which means the library should provide any needed material to the users by giving the services without loss of time or with minimum possible time. That can be happen if the library provides open access. In a closed system, a reader cannot go to the library up to shelf, and they have to request and ask the library staff, which consumes time of the readers. Thus, open access saves the time of the readers as well as the time of the staff. The library should provide guides. A library guide is used to display the reading materials. This helps users to locate books without wasting their time. Libraries should provide proper boards, which should be placed before each section, such as religion, language, reference books, and many more. The very important law is fifth law. Library is a growing organism. This law represents the planning, coordination, and organization of library. Library materials, rules, physical library should be updated over time. The library growth should be very important. To improve its collection and to get more users, library should have a proper scientific method for a good classification scheme. They should adopt a proper classification scheme. Library should have done indexing of the library collection by its author, title, subject entries, with the growth in number of books. The size of catalog should be adjusted too. The library should make effective library services. Qualified trained staff to be recruited in the library. because the mutual understanding and cooperation will be profitable for library and also for its growth. Growth in the library will also increase circulation work in future. Therefore, to run library successfully and its circulation, a proper issue system should be provided. The library should grow with the technology. It is very important to grow with technology because users are born with technology. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any query, then write to us in comment box.